for yourself in the way in which we've now just spoken about thinking. I'm also committed to not being a windbag tonight. And that's like not being a guy in a diner. I promised you early not to give you my opinion, not to tell you what I think, what I like, what I don't like, what I want, what I don't want. I want to read you this really wonderful quote from Max Weber. He says, I am under the impression that in 9 out of 10 cases I deal with windbags. Probably hung out with pretty good people if his batting average was that good. But anyway, he says, I am under the impression that in 9 out of 10 cases I deal with windbags who do not fully realize what they take upon themselves when they speak and when they listen and when they think and when they act and when, literally, when they are. But who intoxicate themselves with romantic sensations. Like, I believe may be a romantic sensation. My experience has proven may be a romantic sensation. Everybody knows may be a romantic sensation. Everybody, all the best people know. I read may be a romantic sensation. From a human point of view, this is not very interesting to me, nor does it move me profoundly. However, it is immensely moving when a mature person, whether old or young in years, is aware of a responsibility for the consequences of his speaking. See, you and I don't take our speaking very seriously. We have no sense that we are our word. In fact, we pretty much don't trust each other's word anymore. The one way not to get elected is make promises. Nobody trusts you if you promise. Is aware of a responsibility for the consequences of his speaking, of his conduct, and really feels such a responsibility with heart and soul. He then acts by following the ethic of responsibility. By the way, responsibility doesn't mean here blame or guilt or fault. Something much more profound. Something not like you and I ordinarily mean when we say, I'm responsible for that. He's talking about something more profound. At any rate, he goes on to say he then acts following the ethic of responsibility, and somewhere he reaches the point where he says, here I stand. You don't hear that very much, do you? You hear, I'm here because. Let me tell you what's right about why I'm here. Let me tell you why I'm here. Let me prove to you that here is the right place. No, he says, and somewhere he reaches the point where he says, here I stand, I can do no other. That is something genuinely human and moving. And every one of us who is not spiritually dead must realize the possibility of finding himself at some time in that position. So tonight is about that position, or rather,